The title is not clickbait. So back about 4 months ago, I started getting this brown spot on my eye and it was itching. So I saw a dermatologist and she said, I don't know what it is. You have to get a biopsy. It might be basal cell carcinoma, which is the least problematic of all the skin cancers. There's three main skin cancers. And then in the meantime, after that, I saw my mold doctor and he said it might be squamous cell, which is the medium skin cancer. But you don't know until you get the biopsy. So then I saw a specialist and she said, don't know what it is, get a biopsy, but it looks like melanoma. So melanoma is the worst skin cancer. It kills people. Squamous cell also does too. So that was 5-6 weeks ago when I saw the specialist for the first time. And she said, you could get a biopsy right now and we'll take a little bit, we'll put a stitch there, or you can wait and see what happens. And we can set up another appointment like 5-6 weeks from now. So I said, let's wait, and I pay everything's cash. My insurance, my medical insurance deductible is like $9,000. So I came back a week and a half ago, I saw her again, she looked at it, she measured it, she said, it's smaller and it's flatter. So how can I get that little itchy brown spot to get smaller and flatter? Ketosis. Now, I've been dealing with the carnivore diet, trying to make it my lifestyle for about 5 months, and it wasn't too successful. And I didn't put too much effort into it, maybe, 30% effort into trying to go carnivore. And in the meantime, that's when this thing popped up. So then after that, I got real serious, and then I've been in ketosis every day for just over 2 weeks, and that's why it's smaller. So I probably won't ever get the biopsy done as long as it keeps getting smaller and smaller, and I'll remain in ketosis. All right, so there's the thing with that. Even when I was a kid, I always kind of knew I'm gonna end up with skin cancer. I always get sunburned in the summertime, fair-skinned. And there's a guy named Tucker Goodrich. I mentioned this last week in a lecture that I did. I put it on YouTube. He removed all the seed oils, also known as vegetable oils, out of his diet. And he doesn't sunburn anymore. And there's people coming out, they remove those bad fats, the vegetable oils, out of their diet, and they're not burning anymore. So that can tell you that those vegetable oils are a major contributor to sunburn and probably skin cancer. All right, so do I have melanoma? I don't know, because I refused the biopsy twice now, but whatever that spot is, it's getting smaller. Okay, the next thing I want to go over is related to eating carnivore. The point is, the more meat that you eat, you end up eating less food. And I have an example of this using Chronometer, the app that keeps track of your food. I put my food in there, and on one particular day, I had an 18-ounce steak, and I total was 1,400 calories for the day. I had one cup of coconut milk, but the 18-ounce steak with all the protein and the coconut milk, I was so satisfied. And then on day two, I had 2,400 calories, and I had a 24-ounce steak and other foods too. So I'm very full after 2 days of eating steak and fat. And then on day three, I could only eat 357 calories the whole day. And I ended up having like one lamb burger and something else, and that's all I could handle because I was so full from 2 days of eating red meat. Okay, so that's an example of how you can eat less food from eating meat. Okay, I got two more things I want to go over. The next one is how to gain muscle with ketosis. Here's how you do it. Here's how our ancestors did it. So you actually have to fast. And when you come out of the fast, then you lift weights and you're eating a lot of fat and protein. That's how you gain muscle. So imagine our ancestors, they would kill a large herbivore, like a deer or moose or whatever, and they would eat that for a week, let's say. And now they're not hungry, even after the week is over, 2 days, 3 days go by, now they're starting to get hungry again. They're in ketosis. And then on the fourth day, it rains, so they're not gonna go hunting, maybe. And then on the fifth day, now they're gonna go hunting. So in ketosis, their bodies have greater reflexes, their brains work better, and better utilization of ketones for endurance energy and muscular strength. So their body's preparing to kill the next large animal. They kill it, they eat it, And the body now wants to be even more prepared for the next hunt. So if you time this right, if you work this situation out correctly, you can gain muscular weight and maybe even fat by doing this cycle of fasting and then gorging on meat and protein and lifting weights. So having said that, I have to say I weigh more now than ever in my life. I've always been thin, graduating from high school, 6'1", 155 pounds. I was that for 20 years. And I was so thrilled to get to 162. I hung out between 155 and 162 for years. And then now I can hit 180, 183. So it's because I'm eating so much more meat, I'm getting into ketosis, I'm lifting weights, and I'm fasting. So it's the fasting is the key. It's a key part of gaining muscle weight and gaining body weight. So you fast and you eat fat and protein and you're lifting weights. So just work that out that way. The last thing I want to say is that my girlfriend lives in Chicago. She's also a chiropractor and she also focuses a lot on nutrition. And she runs a lot more blood tests than I do. One is called the bone resorption test. It's a finger prick, just a little bit of blood. You put it on a paper, you send it to the lab, and they can tell you if you are resorbing bone, if you're in an osteoporotic condition or not. And so she runs that test on a lot of women, as opposed to doing a bone density test, because an actual bone density test is only paid for by the insurance like every 2 years. So anyways, in the last year, she's had 7 women reverse their osteoporosis, not just stop it, because you can stop it with a medication, but actually reverse it. And of course, what do the MDs say? They say, well, the first diagnosis was incorrect, or maybe the machine's broken, or something like that. So anyways, I'm just sharing with you, 7 patients have reversed their osteoporosis. Having said that, I do want to add one more thing. I have one of my practitioners here who has a patient whose thyroid was not performing very well at all, and she was getting better, and the blood test showed it, and she was feeling better, and she needed less of her thyroid medication. So she goes to her MD and says, I'm doing these healthy things, and I need less medication. And the doctor got really, really mad, and the doctor kept saying, thyroids don't get better, like hammering that into the patient's head. And I'm sure that was hammered into the doctor's head in medical school, that thyroids don't get better, osteoporosis doesn't get better, diabetes doesn't get better, cancer doesn't get better. That's what they're taught. So, you know, if you're one of those rare Americans that's actually getting better, or whatever country you live in, you're rare. There's not that many people actually getting better. And you go to a doctor and it just blows their brain because they may have been in practice for 20 years and they may have never seen anybody get better. So just hold your ground. If your lab tests show it and you feel better, don't let somebody take that away from you. All right, those are my thoughts. Thanks for listening. If you want to be patient, it's best to call the office. The phone number is below. You can also email us. And if you like this video, please share, subscribe, give me a thumbs up, hit the bell for notifications. All right, thanks.